Hot 107.9, Miss Shymeika right here holding it down. Got a very special guest in the studio. Ash Cash, how are you?
I'm doing wonderful.
I know that ain't your government, but we just gonna call you Ash Cash because that's what you want us to call you.
It's Googleable, so you know they think it is.
Yeah,
it's Ash Exantis. So either way,
okay,
it's easier to say Ash Cash and know that I'm the money man.
So. I know that's right. Look at you working with the title that I gave you. You the money man.
Right.
You know you can go by financial educator, business consultant, author, all that stuff. But they like, oh, that's the man that can get us some money.
Right.
Are we tuning in 4 o'clock? Hot 107.9. So what's going on, man? How are you?
I'm good. Just happy to be here, you know, excited to spread knowledge, help us, you know, build some wealth, change our relationship with money.
Yes.
You know, that's what it's about.
Helping us help ourselves.
Absolutely.
Out here in these streets. All right, 2020, everybody has all these visions.
Yes.
To, you know, manifest all of these money blessings.
Yes.
That are currently, man, so many different ways to obtain money. But as you know, there are a lot of people out here that are, you know, hurting.
Yeah.
They are living check to check. Mm-hmm. They aren't able to really save money. Mm-hmm. And I just wanted to bring in somebody that could help them out. And, you know, tax season is coming upon us. I have not seen not a one W-2 at all.
Yeah. They're going to wait to the end.
I have not seen one. But I want to know, you know, as they are preparing to receive their W-2s and get their tax refund, we are advertising a lot of tax companies right now. What are some things that they can do to, you know, start saving money or creating some kind of source of revenue?
Yeah, so I think number one, so there's three things I think people should do when they get their tax money.
Mm-hmm.
I think number one, what they're going to do already is spend some of it, right? And so, you know, I definitely think you should spend some of it. But I definitely think that you need to save some of it as well.
Right.
And then you also need to take a piece of that tax return and invest it in income-producing assets. And when I say income-producing assets, I'm saying, you know, buy something that's going to help you change your relationship with money. So that way you're not only working for money, but you're allowing that money to work for you.
Okay.
Because when you think about taxes is one of the biggest amount of money, the lump sum that people are going to get. And so this is actually the fact that you get it in the beginning of the year.
Mm-hmm.
Is the time that you should really, you know, take action and really start to put the money into place. The reason why I want people to save money, though, because, you know, I'm a believer in the law of attraction and people attracting things to them. And so from a practical perspective, when people are saving money and you know that you have money,
right,
you're not operating in lack. And when you're not operating in lack, you're able to attract more to you, right?
Uh-huh.
Now, when you start investing in income-producing assets, and when I say income-producing assets, I'm saying, you know, potentially, you know, saving up for a down payment to buy a house or property, or, you know, starting that business, right? Because you could actually, you know, start a business, you know, with a little bit of money, right? You can start,
mm-hmm,
an online business. There's just so much things that you could do. And so those things, when you put that money in it, you allow it to, you know, make money for you. So that's what I think people should do.
That's right. And I think it's important that I say this. Whatever business it is that you invest your money, your resources in, it has to be something that you are actually passionate
about. Yes.
You know, and that's how you draw in, you know, these blessings.
Absolutely.
Like, to me, most people want you to invest in a business, like, you know, a baby daddy, boyfriend, cousin, your cousin,
right.
Oh, I got this business idea, but it's not your passion and your effort that's driving it. And so it's important that it is something that you actually want to dedicate your time to doing.
Absolutely. And that's the thing, because, you know, I think a lot of times people are focused on the money first and foremost, like, what can I do to get money? But like you said, I think that, you know, if you're going to invest in something, invest in something that you're passionate about, invest in something that you love, because that passion, that love is what's going to bring the money ultimately.
That's right. We have more to talk about. Ash Cash in the building, the money man. Keep it locked in right here.